In the energy quadrant today, we saw crude oil jump to 39.17. That's the August crude oil futures contract. That was the high, up 2.5% on that high, finishing the day a little bit better than 2% higher on the day with pretty good volume. As a matter of fact, you saw the energy sector in the equity markets be one of the strongest performing sectors of the day, actually up near 2% itself at one point, coming off a little bit later in the day. But that was a pretty strong gain considering that crude oil has been up toward 40 twice now. It's touched 42 times, fell short of it today. But if it goes up there again, third day, that would be a third time up at 40. That would be a triple top. Triple tops tend to continue. Doesn't have to happen, but historically, they do tend to continue in the direction of the triple top. So that would be up to 40. And then there's a gap in about the 42.25 level that you could likely see filled if we were to get up in there with some volume. Today, we didn't get through there, but we did have volume. OPEC Plus meeting ended this morning, so yesterday their time, and no extended cuts past the end of July date that they currently have. No recommendations for additional cuts, but what we did have is a discussion of compliance from some of the countries that have been bad at that, complying with the cuts. It's not enough to have the actual cuts in place, but the market has to feel the pain of the lower supply in order to get those prices higher, and that seemed to be the focus of this meeting, compliance and enforcement. So we'll see if that happens, but that helped in the crude oil bid that we got today, a little bit of a boost there talking about that compliance. We already knew how many barrels they had proclaimed they were going to cut. Now, at least you can say they're looking to enforce that particular number of barrels in the cut. Lastly, we are seeing some small green shoots, some signs of demand in the fuel side of the crude oil equation. The gasoline side, we had a draw from the EIA of 1.7 million barrels that was behind a crude oil build, so it didn't really affect yesterday. But something to look at that I talk about quite a bit is refinery utilization, which was up to 73.8. It's the highest we've seen in about 8 or 9 weeks. And actually, first time we've seen refinery utilization above 70%, three times in a row since the start of those streaks of 60s that we got again about 10 weeks ago or so. So it's a pretty good sign to see that refineries are actually starting to utilize their processes to produce fuel, and they wouldn't do that unless they thought demand was coming. So it is potentially a sign of some demand growth.